In 5, 4, 3, 2.
FM.
Today's Friday, May 8th.
I'm Sim.
I'm Cyrus.
I'm Emma.
I'm Lizzie.
I'm Milo Sinclair.
And today's announcements.
The M might have been canceled like so many other things this year, but many of us were already fundraising well before the pandemic hit. One thing that hasn't changed with COVID-19 is that kids around our community are still negatively impacted by cancer, and Camp Good Day still needs our help.
Our hope is that you will mail in your checks in your packets or donate the entrance fee to DM if you are already planning on paying for it anyway, to Mr. O'Brien in the SAO. See his Schoology update from Wednesday for the details. Camp Good Days is still counting on us to make a difference. Speaking of canceled things we are still sad about, we now offer you a Pi Day Mulligan Rubik's Cube challenge from an unlikely source, the English department.
Hi everybody! So I've had some free time over the past few weeks and I thought I would perfect my skills at the Rubik's Cube. And since we didn't get to have the Pi Day assembly, I figured we could do our own digital or remote Rubik's Cube challenge. So I'm going to do it, see how fast I can do this, and then see if any of you can beat me. Done. 146. If any of you think you can beat that, do a recording of yourself with a timer and shoot me an email at eletsf@fmschools.org and we'll see who wins. Good luck.
Thanks, Miss Lutz. We will hopefully have some challenges for you in the week ahead and maybe a new Rubik's Cube champion. If any other teachers are feeling inspired and want to issue a bold challenge to the student body, please let us know. We'd love to share your competitive spirit and talents with the world. Mark your calendars. The district has come up with a plan to honour the class of 2020 next Friday, May 15th, by lighting up the FM Stadium from 8:20 to 8:40 p.m. and inviting students and families to drive past the stadium during that time to show their support. Families are also encouraged to decorate their houses and lawns to show their Hornet pride and send pictures to their class officers.
Looking for another way to support this year's seniors? The FM Education Foundation is selling double-sided yard signs recognizing this year's senior class. Personalized signs are $20 and signs without personalizations are $15. In light of the pandemic and its impact on students, this year they are providing each FM class of 2020 member with one non-personalized sign at no cost. Families do not need to pre-order this complimentary sign, but can purchase a vinyl sticker that affixes to the sign and is personalized with a graduate's name for $5. That's a steal. Orders must be placed online by May 15th and signs will be delivered to homes through contactless delivery by May 31st.
Need a new book to read? Here's Ms. Petros talking about new podcast programs on the library website that offers book readings and reviews.
Good morning, FM. Welcome back to the quiet side of the library. We're going to be talking to you today about another way to stay smart during the closure. We have decided to start a podcast from the library where we talk about books. Every Friday, we will be posting a podcast called First Chapter Friday, where we'll be reading the first chapter of a book that we have in our collection or that's accessible to you through ebooks or audiobooks through our website. So if you go to our website, you'll see that there's now a tab that says podcast, and you can see here that we have the first one already posted, and the transcript is below it, along with information about how to access that book if you'd like to read it. I'm gonna give it over to Mrs. Kleckner, who's gonna tell you about the first book.
The first episode of our new podcast features Enchanted Air by Margarita Engel. This is the story of Margarita growing up as a Cuban-American during the Cold War. She's torn between her life in Los Angeles and her life in Cuba and how she can represent both. If you're a fan of a quick read, This is a great choice because it's written in verse and it moves quickly. You can move through each of the verses quickly and on to the next. So take a look at the podcast, check out the first episode, and maybe you'll be interested in reading. You can find how to access it digitally right below the podcast episode.
For the second episode, I decided to go way outside my comfort zone to read a futuristic dystopic sci-fi novel by Neil Schusterman called Scythe. And it's the first in a series of books that are going to be made into films. We thought you'd be interested because of that. And also it's one of the works chosen for the Battle of the Books for next year. So this is an interesting book because it imagines a world in which there's no disease anymore, there's no hunger, so you can understand why that would be something interesting to us at this point. But like all dystopic fictions, the way that you get those things is by giving something up, and it might be something that's very valuable. So the main characters are two young people, they're high school students, who live in a world that in any, every other way looks very much like our own world, except that because there's no disease and no hunger, the way that they keep the population down is there are these characters who are called scythes. And if you know what a scythe is, if you've ever seen the Grim Reaper, it's that tool that the Grim Reaper has to cut us down. And it's, of course, that symbolic for the Grim Reaper, but it's real. It's a very real image in this book. And these two high school students have been chosen to be apprentices to become scythes, to take out members of the population. So it's full of ethical issues. It's very interesting. There are some problems with it as well, which we'll talk about in a future episode after we've all read it together. So if you're interested, go to our podcast tab on the website and choose the second podcast, Neil Schusterman's Scythe. So when you want to read Scythe, one of the ways you can get there is from our catalog. So when you go to the website, click on Search Catalog. It will ask you to log in, which you can do with Google. It's very easy. Just click on Google, and you'll notice that one of the options is a Follett ebook. Here's a great thing about the Follett ebook. If you check it out, only one person can read it at a time, which means that others don't have access to it. But maybe a lot of people want to read this together. So the way that you can get around the problem of checking it out to one person is by clicking on Open. That way, lots of different people can be reading the book at the same time. So you don't have to actually check it out. You just click open, and you'll be able to read it. One of the really nice things about our podcast, we think, is that you will be able to read a book, but be totally screen-free.
So we really hope you enjoy the podcast. Be sure to keep an eye out. We're going to have more content coming soon. Have a great day, FM.
Have a great day, FM.
Well, that's all we have for today.
Have a good day, FM.